What's going on, guys? J&M Studios Gaming here. I'm Michael. First off, let's just say I'm sorry. Because I was going to get you my very first gameplay on Madden 18. Because I downloaded the demo. And apparently it's only for like a couple days. So now I got back on my PS4 after being grounded from grades. And yeah, it wouldn't let me play. So we're going back to 17. No, I have not bought 18 yet because I don't have any money right now. I've never had money lately, so yeah, I'm stuck with like crappy 17. So this basically just gonna be gameplay. Broncos versus Eagles. Because on Sunday, as you know, Broncos and Eagles are playing. And I'm just gonna like edit the roster and everything, because as you know, Brock Osweiler will be starting. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I won't be doing that much commentary. So yeah, enjoy the video. Trevor Siemian, you suck. I hate you. Get benched, son. As you know, Paxton Lynch is hurt, so obviously you can't really do that. Thank you.
turn up. I'm breaking in, I'm at the pearly gates, but they won't let it in. I told the devil, I said, f*** him, I ain't trying to sin, yeah. I ain't trying to sin, yeah. Pray to the Lord, daddy, let me in.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. Here we've got a couple of big targets who will try to be key contributors in both the pass and run games today. It's the Broncos going up against the Eagles. With that, let's get out to Lincoln Financial Field. Here are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Denver Broncos and the Philadelphia Eagles. Hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we saw Larry focus on the tight end matchup in his open. You think it's one to watch, don't you?
Definitely one to watch because these guys can create such big plays by all the different things they can do. Line up out wide, in the slot, line up in a normal tight end position, and then who are you going to cover them with? Is it a linebacker, a defensive back? They create mismatches all throughout the game.
Caleb Sturgis now to do the honors and get us started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. So here are the Broncos now for their opening drive. They'll be led out by the second tallest quarterback in league history at 6'7". It's Brock Osweiler.
I saw Brock Osweiler throw in a practice session while he was in college, and it's never left me the memory of how smooth he was throwing the ball, how accurate he was, and what a catchable ball he threw.
Now it's Osweiler. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. 12 yards on the pickup, and it'll be first down, Denver. Sanders, the former SMU product, had 79 catches last year, over 1,000 yards, 5 touchdowns. They're going to need more of him in Denver if they want to get back into the playoffs.
Part of a great tandem, he and Demaryius Thomas, and Demaryius plays out wide. He's one of those guys that you send him out there and let him work one-on-one and use his big body, his big frame to get open. Emmanuel Sanders, he has the ability to work inside as well, and he's not just quick, he's also fast, and he's dependable for a quarterback because a lot of the routes he runs are right in the sight line. Easy throws for a QB.
Again on 2nd and 10 now, it's Osweiler. And he will find his man for the first time, Demaryius Thomas. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down.
Well, the bad news, the Denver Broncos didn't make the playoffs, but the good news for Demaryius Thomas, he was over 1,000 yards again as a receiver.
6th straight year he's done that, but yards per catch and touchdowns down a little bit. Any of that due to the change at quarterback?
Think about it. For him now, in the last 2 seasons, he's had to get used to 4 different quarterbacks throwing him the football. I think that yards per catch will go back up when he gets some consistency.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. 3rd and 2 is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the 1st down.
And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on, and it's 2nd down. Defensive side of the ball for the Eagles. Here they are, the starting 11. And you were telling me before the game, taking this from your knowledge bank, that if they need to improve anywhere in 2017, maybe in the secondary. Is that right?
I think you're right on that one, because I think they're very happy with Malcolm Jenkins and Rodney McLeod down the middle as the safeties. But they'd love to make an upgrade on the corner position, because if you're playing in the NFC East, there are some guys who go out and get the football. And then think up front, they're looking for a bigger year from Fletcher Cox. defense. He's their bell cow on defense, a defensive tackle, defensive end. They need to have that all-pro season from him again in 2017.
A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
That was a nice completion on an out route, and those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
They'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40. Timmy Jernigan, the Florida State man, in on the stop.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got a problem.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Ronald Darby. He's got the lane, and there he goes. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD.
And the defense could not have written a much better script than that first drive, pick six.
The offense never got a chance to really get oiled up there, did they? But the defense, they certainly got in gear. What a big-time play and a great way for them to start.
And now the offense, they've got to turn things around and figure this out because your backs are on the ground real quickly.
Yeah, usually when you're starting the game, getting the ball, 0-0 is the only score you're worried about. Now the second time you get it, you're already down a touchdown.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
His throw incomplete.
Holding offense.
So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Demaryius Thomas, the intended receiver, and now it's fourth down.
He's not exactly had a banner start to this game. We're still in the first quarter. He's already thrown an interception, and that should have been the second one.
And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. Thomas, the lone receiver left. They'll indeed go for it with Osweiler. And this is incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
All right, here we go. Boo, Danny! Boo, Danny!
Back to the air, Osweiler after the pick six. Looking again for Thomas, this time complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They try the corner route there, Charles, and it works to perfection.
Boy, that's hard on a defensive back because if you get any fake or move to the inside, you have to respect it, and then the receiver breaks back to the sideline.
Virgil Green is tight end, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
They come out here in the eye. Second and 10 now. Osweiler surveying the field. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Well, it's like that at just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
third down, Osweiler. And Fowler's got it. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game. We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive back. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
His throw caught right around the six. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Emmanuel Sanders, an 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Broncos have cut it to within a score. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, so the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. They come out here in the eye. They go play action here on first down. Sanders has it over the middle. Give him 22 on that one. And it's a first down for the Broncos.
Here we go now. Boom, landed.
Now a play fake here on first down. Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Nigel Bradham. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. So the Broncos coming out now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more caught? Emmanuel Sanders! And all the way home for a Broncos score! Emmanuel Sanders with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Broncos able to show off their quick strike ability. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can...
After a good punt, this offense will start with tough field position inside the 10. And Denver getting set to take the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right? Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Thomas, the lone receiver, left. Throwing now, Osweiler on first down. Over the middle, it's Thomas. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. It's a pickup of 19. And it'll be good for a Denver first down. From midfield now, here's Osweiler. Over the middle, this time to Fowler. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On first down, Osweiler. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Emmanuel Sanders, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
In the backfield is Anderson. To throw is Osweiler. And this is caught inside the five. A very solid gain of 27. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
Now let's go. 319. Detroit! Detroit!
They'll run for it with Anderson. And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. C.J. Anderson. Drop you into the start of this next possession. The score, 7-0. And Denver getting set to take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
An incomplete, crisis averted, almost picked. Instead, second down. Let's look ahead for a quick minute. We don't have the schedules yet for next year, but what we do have are the five international games that will be played, four in London and then one again in Mexico, Jacksonville, Baltimore, Miami, New Orleans, Cleveland, Minnesota, Rams, and Arizona. Those in London, and then Mexico's going to get a great game. The Raiders and New England.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And just think about the ones in London. Remember, they're splitting them between the two different stadiums in London. So they get a different flavor in all of these places. But Mexico, for the second straight year, the Raiders are coming to town. That should be a whole lot of fun.
Should be a ton of fun and a very good matchup.
Not only did they drop, it looked like an interception in the end zone. They blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
They'll come out in the pistol. Second and 10 now, Osweiler. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Demaryius Thomas, as the first half is winding down, and the Broncos have taken the lead.
And while that touchdown does not give them an insurmountable lead, it's still a lead, and that always...
So following the fumble, this offense will get another shot at it as they quickly head back onto the field. One receiver left, three to the right. Osweiler, he's going to let this one go for Latimer. And that's going to be too high, out of bounds and incomplete. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we send you down to Orlando where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Eagles trail right now, but with another half to play, there's time to turn it around. The Broncos have been the better team, though, and will try to maintain the lead in the second half. All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Broncos have it at the 19. Osweiler's gonna find his mark, and he's gonna go 19 yards for the score. Deficit shrinks to 10. Now first and 10, Emmanuel Sanders making a catch coming across the middle, and it's gonna end up going for a gain of 22. The offense will head off after throwing the interception. Now it's a shot after the interception. Quick pass and Sanders with the catch. And this play will go for 6, cutting the deficit to 10. Broncos have it late in the second. Osweiler's got the completion here, and he'll be tackled at the 1-yard line. Still a little time left on the clock. Anderson's going to stay inside after the handoff, and he'll end up sprinting into the end zone. Now trailing by just 3. Still late in the first half, the long ball will find its mark here, and this 5-play drive goes for a touchdown. The lead grows to 4. That'll do it for us here at EA Sports Studios. Let's get back out to Brandon and Charles for the call of the second half. Brandon.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This will be taken in at the 1. Oh, he pulls over it. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Out come the Eagles now as he'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up.
And we drop you into the start of this next possession. The score, 7-0. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Osweiler. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. They'll get 17 yards there, and it'll be first down, Denver. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
On second down, Anderson. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves them needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine. So third down, they need to get to the 28 for a first. Out of the gun, it's Osweiler. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. That one goes for 29 yards on third down. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day? You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Gardens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like they're drawing them up in the dirt, and so far it's working for both of them.
It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Call it a gain of two as they're knocking on the door now. Third and goal.
Were you as surprised as I was that they actually ran it on second down there? I thought that they would go ahead and throw it in every situation here.
They've thrown for three touchdown passes now. Here, I think they probably go back to the air.
Yeah, I think so. But ordinarily, second down is when you run your play fake, your play action, show run, and throw the ball. Now they brought up third down. They'll have to throw it anyway. So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. So it's only 3 points on this opening drive of the third quarter, and even though that... drop you into the start of this next possession. The score, 7-0. In the backfield is Anderson. And they'll give it to him here. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24. Give the tackle that time to Rodney McLeod.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set him up.
Over the middle, open is Thomas. The reception good for 7. It's third down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
Now Osweiler. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people and bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
Finding his target, it's Cody Latimer. Legs still churning.
Like a giant pinball.
And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. And now he's closing in on 450 yards passing.
That's an incredible number. I mean, you're talking about the best defenders in the world that you're trying to throw the ball against, and you're creating that type of a number. Fantastic job, fantastic performance. And he's going to have to ice up his arm afterwards, too.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be
daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them. Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Now it's Osweiler, Demaryius Thomas, the intended receiver, and fourth down coming up.
I think that's a big-time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick, but able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he's able to bat it away.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. They're going on fourth down. It's Osweiler toward the sideline. He will have the first down. Good catch. He was able to keep the feet in bounds.
I remember in pregame when we were talking to him on the field and he took his gloves off and showed us his fingers. A few misshapen ones in there, and now we know why they're trying to catch those types of bullets.
That was a dart. Yeah, even for a talented receiver, those are tough to hang on to. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Back to the ground. This time it's Anderson. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. And now for the offense. This is play number 11 here on this drive. And the Eagles will go with an extra DB here as they prepare for a stop on third.
Thinking pass all the way.
Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. And they're facing a big third down now in this tie ball game. Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. On third down, Osweiler. That's caught at the three. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three.
Offense.
So oftentimes you see defensive holding. Here it's offensive holding for the flag. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. There's some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. And McManus able to put it through. And they have taken the lead here in the final 2 minutes. And we drop you into the start of this next possession. The score, 7-0. Backfield is Anderson, and he'll get it up the middle. And the spin looked pretty, but more for style points as the real estate evaporated quickly there. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
So, Brandon, when this offense gathers together to watch tape for this game, they're going to be feeling pretty good about themselves until the coaches get upset about the play we just saw. But you know their defense is going to be. But we put up big points all game long. The defense is going to win one every now and then.
Snap to the up man, and the gamble pays off. They get the first. Well, I know at points sense of this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard. You're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal. That's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. With that, we say so long from Philly.